The range of warships used by the Confederacy of Independent Systems was generally far more varied than that of the Galactic Republic, including designs contributed by separatist worlds and manufacturers across the galaxy. While this may have made the Confederate fleet less uniform and distinct, it offered a level of versatility that the Republic sometimes lacked. Developed by Hirsch Kessel Drive Incorporated, the DH Omni was originally a civilian superfreighter that was later converted into a military support craft for use by the Confederacy. The ships were most often seen as part of planetary invasion fleets, where their stored complements of C-9979 landing craft were used to ferry battalions of battle droids to a planet's surface. The DH Omni was armed only with point defense weapons, but was able to carry a number of strike craft for defensive purposes. The ship's greatest advantage was its huge 5 million ton cargo capacity, used to carry vast quantities of arms, equipment, vehicles, and droids across the galaxy. The most ubiquitous warship of the Confederate Navy, the Hirsch Kessel Munificent Class Star Frigate, was designed to serve as the backbone of any Confederate fleet, working in groups to form a powerful bulwark at the front of any formation, and coordinating volleys of fire to break through the shields of powerful warships. Armed with a largely forward-facing arrangement of weapons, the Munificent is able to create a deadly cone of fire that few ships can penetrate, but the vessel is extremely vulnerable to flanking attacks, presenting virtually no armor across its aft quarter from any direction. This, coupled with the ship's lack of strike craft, leaves the frigate heavily reliant on accompanying vessels and squadrons to protect it from bomber wings. Contributed to the Confederate Navy by the Commerce Guild, the Hirsch Kessel Recusant Class Light Destroyer plays an aggressive anti-capital role in a separatist battle line. The ship is heavily automated, using numerous droid brains to control ship systems under the supervision of a 300-strong crew. The forward-facing turbo lasers of the Recusant Class are impressively powerful, able to swiftly defeat the shields of even Venator-class Star Destroyers when brought into close range. But the ship's skeletal space frame is lacking in armor, and as a result, the vessel is often escorted closely by Munificent or Providence-class warships. Designed by the Free DAC Volunteers Engineering Corps, the Providence-class carrier destroyer was designed to accommodate for the lack of fighter bays on most smaller Confederate warships. The vessel's through-deck launch bay was able to carry a huge contingent of strike craft, including fighters, interceptors, bombers, and gunships. The armament and defenses of the Providence-class were extremely impressive, presenting a serious rival for the Republic's iconic Venator-class Star Destroyer. The design of the Providence was so popular that the CIS eventually assembled a scaled-up dreadnought version of the same frame, used in some of the most crucial battles of the Clone Wars. Converted from the LH-3210 superfreighters of the Trade Federation, the Hirsch Kessel Lucrehulk-class battleship was one of the largest vessels to take part in the Clone Wars, dwarfing the capital ships of the Galactic Republic and carrying a colossal supply of troops, vehicles, and strike craft beneath heavy armor and powerful shields. Lucrehulks were most often placed at the center of Confederate battle groups, where their lack of maneuverability would be mitigated by defensive formations, and their incredible durability could be used to absorb fire from multiple enemy ships. With a troop complement of over 300,000 battle droids, a single Lucrehulk was more than capable of occupying a minor world without any support, and offered a powerful operations platform and coordination center for occupying forces. Built in extremely small numbers by the Free DAC Engineering Corps, the Subjugator-class heavy cruiser was one of the largest and most fearsome warships ever deployed at the time of its launch. Built around a pair of prototype ion cannons fixed amidships, the colossal warship was able to disable and destroy entire flotillas of Star Destroyers in short order, and was responsible for heavy losses among the Republic Navy in the first year of the war. The Subjugator is best known as the class of the warship Malevolence, a vessel that played a crucial role in the Confederate war effort throughout the earliest months of the conflict. The ship was singularly responsible for the destruction of multiple Republic fleets and had a serious effect on the balance of power between the two warring factions. The vessel was eventually destroyed in the Battle of the Kalida Nebula, but not before seriously weakening the structure of the Republic Navy. Thank you for watching Spacedock. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share for more science fiction spacecraft summaries. If you enjoy the channel, why not consider pledging your support on Patreon? For just $1 a month, you'll be able to access the Spacedock schedule to see what's coming up.